Welcome to the vibrant city of Tirana, Albania, whose history and modern flair has so much to offer the traveler. So in this video, we'll cover 20 things that stole our hearts in this enchanting city, from its incredible landscapes to its delicious food and everything in between. Unfortunately though, it was not all sunshine and rainbows during our stay. So we're also gonna tackle two aspects of Tirana that left us a little less enamored. So buckle up for a roller coaster ride through the highs and lows of Tirana. All in this episode of Lucas World Travel.
And I'm David.
And we're Lucas World Travel, here to help you navigate the world affordably. First up is we always like to take a walking tour whenever we go to a new city. And we really loved our tour here. The guide was able to give us a lot of information about his personal experience living through communism here in Albania. I'll put the link to the tour in the description box below. It's a free tour that is tipped based, so give what you can when you go. During our walking tour, we got to learn about Albania's national hero, Skanderbeg, who has a lovely statue in the middle of Skanderbeg Square. We also visited some lovely churches that we would have missed on our own, including the Resurrection of Christ Orthodox Church and St. Paul's Cathedral, which has some lovely artwork of Mother Teresa inside it. It was also interesting to see the former residence of Enver Hoxha, who was the man who led Albania into communism. It was such a great and informative tour that we even made friends along the way and went out for beers and great local food at restaurant Taimi. This mosque was built in 1819, and it's one of the few mosques that survived communism after 1940. During the times of communism in Albania, they tore down all the churches and the mosques. They preserved this one just as cultural history, and you can see why by all the beautiful paintings that are both outside and inside. Now, when they're not having services, you can go in there, and I highly recommend it because the prayer room is gorgeous. So it costs 200 lek to climb up 90 stairs in this clock tower to see a view of the square. So from the clock tower, you get a great view from Skanderbeg Square, as well as the mountains in the distance. The view is lovely, and it's worth the 200 lek fee. This museum commemorates all the people who were killed during the communist times or forced into work labor camps. And you can see some of the people who died because they were opponents of the communist party on the walls here. border and Albanians were not allowed to leave the country. And they used dogs like this in order to patrol the borders. Anybody caught trying to cross the border illegally was killed. So now I'm going to decontaminate myself from the pandemic. Thing you can do in Tirana is take a walk through the cloud. So this is a really nice art display, and in the summer you can sit here in the cloud and watch movies on the big screen over there. Interesting idea. So unfortunately my purse broke, so I've been walking around the city with this grocery bag. Gotta go shopping, gotta get a new purse. Let's do this. A great place to shop in Tirana is Topani Mall. Luckily, I was able to find a much more durable handbag there. Another good place to shop and eat is Tirana Castle, which has a fabulous atmosphere at night. And we're walking to the bus stop to take the cable cars. And we'll show you how to get there.
To get the bus that says porcelain, usually it's an L11.
So now it's just a 5-minute walk up the hill to the cable cars, and you can see we're a little bit out of breath. It really wasn't that hard of a journey, and the bus driver was nice and pretty much pointed where we should get off the bus. It's for 1,000 lek return per person. Car is always nice because it's a beautiful vantage point of the city, and it's a nice relaxing scenic ride. I got one of the traditional Tirana casseroles, and it's really good. Very savory gravy with cream and beef. This is really good on a cool day. And the beef is really tender and delicious. So let's chow down. Good and highly recommended. So if you want to fire the air guns, that's 1,000 lek, that's about $10. And if you want to hot ride horses, that's also just 1,000 lek, about $10, which I think is a steal. But I'm a little chilly. I'm not really in the mood to ride a horse today.
Also have four-wheelers. For 1,000 lek, you can make 4 laps around in a four-wheeler. David don't want to get dirty though, so he's refusing to go four-wheeling.
Yeah, because if I get dirt in this thing, it's never going to come out.
Okay.
Man, look at this. I mean, this is fun. This would be the best thing ever, man. This is cool.
So at the top, you have a lot of fun activities to try. I think we're going to pass today, but try those four-wheelers for me. That looks really cool. Now it's time to go back down. But this was a great lunch. So bunk art number one is only 7 minutes away from the cable cars. So we're gonna go ahead and walk there, check it out, and see how it's different than bunk art number two. So if you take the bus all the way out here anyway, might as well do both attractions, the DT cable cars and bunk art number one. Now bunk art number one used to be a nuclear bomb shelter. So let's see what the vibe is like inside here. We got our bunk art tickets and they're 500 lek a piece, but the museum closes at 4 p.m. So we only have about 40 minutes to see everything. Oh, but that's okay. We probably would never get all the way back out here. So 40 minutes is better than no minutes.
Yeah, we can just read the titles and keep it moving.
Keep it moving.
So, Ember Funjao.
So if you pick up the phone, you can hear his voice.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Yeah, that's scary. Okay.
You want to try it?
Yeah, I want to try it. I had no idea.
Our trip through bunk art number one, I really enjoyed it. I actually felt the exhibits were a lot more interesting than bunk art number two. So if you have time, definitely come all the way out here.
Yeah, and come with an open mind because you're gonna really see a lot of crazy stuff from history, and there's parallels to that time and this time now. And it's shocking, but it's also, it's a good reminder that we never want to have to use bunkers like these.
Mm-hmm.
We never want to get to a point where things are so bad that we're thinking that the world might be crushed by military powers. That's a horrible way to have to live your life,
mm-hmm.
to live that kind of lifestyle, live in fear to where you basically have to bury yourself in the ground. That's a horrible feeling.
Yeah. Let's never do anything where we have to bury ourselves in a bunker. But 40 minutes definitely wasn't enough. I'd say allow an hour and a half. We were super rushed, but nonetheless, we enjoyed it and glad we got a chance to do it while we were all the way out of town like this. So we got two tickets to the opera tonight. Now, I'm really excited about this because this will be my very first opera, and I'm interested to see if I like it or not. But tickets were very inexpensive. They were only 1,000 lek per person. That's about $10 per person for a 3-hour complete opera.
Like the first act.
It's So the first act, I felt like the guys in the first act were like players that moved real fast. Like they fell in love in the first 45 minutes. They didn't waste no time doing it either. He was just straight up too. He didn't play around the bush. He was just like, I love you, do you love me? Piece of the Berlin Wall. You might remember when the Berlin Wall came down years ago. So it was this piece was actually given to Albania as a gift, and they display it here in the park. So back in the day, many Albanian people were enslaved and taken to the mines to work, kind of like a concentration camp type of thing. They had to work.
The ground, sir, but most you were like this, all over the country. I mean, just paranoid. These are paranoid, cops are paranoid. We've got many, lots of economy went to these things, everywhere.
So in the X block, you can see all these old bunkers that they used during the communist times. So it's very small and quite smelly in there.
I figured it was.
I don't recommend going in. Now also, across the street from here is the Prime Minister's office. So, let's go check out where the Prime Minister works. So our tour guide said, if you ever see the doors open of the Prime Minister's office, you are allowed to go in there and take a look around. But the two times we passed this building, the doors have been closed, and there's no official schedule of when they're gonna ever open those doors. So it's just the luck of the draw. So good luck when you pass by the Prime Minister's office. So now I'm in Mother Teresa Square, and all around me you can see beautiful buildings like the university campus, the University of Tirana, the University of the Art building. If you walk all the way that way, you'll get back to Skanderbeg Square. And this one is the National Archaeological Museum. Park of Tirana, you have this large artificial lake, which is nice in this landlocked city to have a little bit of a water view. So you can come out, sit by the lakeside bar, and enjoy the view in the park. But this grand park is truly huge with lots of nice walking trails. It's really a pretty place. Another restaurant that we loved is called Oda, which serves traditional Albanian food. It has a great selection of both meat and vegetarian options that was so delicious and flavorful. So some things we really like about Tirana is how affordable it is. Bus fare is only like 40 cents per ride. And food in the restaurants has been really inexpensive and really high quality. So I really do see why people want to live here, because the cost of living is so low. One thing to keep in mind though, you can't drink the water here. So we were on the internet, it says that the water's okay to brush your teeth with and cook with. But I don't think that's true, because David got a little bit of stomach upset doing that. So I wouldn't recommend brushing your teeth or cooking with the water here. So I booked this Airbnb, very affordable in Tirana, Albania. Only $31 a night, and it looks amazing. It's my style, but it's cold as a mug up in here. I had to sleep with my sweater on. We had to sleep in the living room because the bedroom doesn't have a heater.
and the little heat that this little tiny, tiny device is producing is insufficient. Like, how can you enjoy a city when you go home and you're cold and you're uncomfortable? So we choose our, we create our reality. So unfortunately, this choice of place just doesn't fit what we're trying to do here. So we're packing up, booked another Airbnb, and hopefully that place will be more our style.
Although our second accommodation was warmer, it still was not heated to the level that we were used to. And we weren't alone. The people we met in our walking tour also said their accommodations were very cold as well. So if you're traveling to Albania in the winter, just know that they do not heat their venues to a comfortable level. You still have to wear your sweaters and coats inside during the winter, which is one thing we really hated while we were in Tirana.
It has a unit in the bedroom.
So future Kendra and David are here to tell you the second thing we hated when we were in Tirana. Now, we're filming this now because we didn't know if we wanted to put this in the video, but it's been on my heart for a couple of years now, so I think we're putting it in the video. So while we were walking around Tirana, teenage boys would yell out to us, "What's up, my nigga?" And I'm not cool with that. I did not like that at all. It made me very uncomfortable. And they were laughing, giggling, cutting up. I was not having a fun time like they were.
Yeah, well, it's one of those things where, you know, people see these things on television and different things, or they could have been, you know, they could have had bad intentions. Either way, it will make you feel uncomfortable. I know they don't see a lot of black people in this part of the world. And so, you know, it's just one of those things, you know, it's not one of those things that you want to take lightly, but you do want to be aware of it.
Mm-hmm. And this happened twice. It happened both in Tirana and in Durres. So two different cities, two different group of teenage boys. And this has never happened to us anywhere in all of Europe, only in Albania. So I feel the need for my fellow black travelers to kind of warn you about that. The teenage boys might get you.
So, you know, we like to share all the great positive things that we find in the world. But just know also racism exists everywhere. Some levels are higher than others. And also too, these young boys, they were alone. They were not supervised. They probably wouldn't say that around their parents or something like that. But yeah, you know, it's not something that made either of us fans of the area. We probably wouldn't go back. So
that was our journey through Tirana.
So if you like content like this, be sure to like, subscribe, share, ring that bell to be notified for our next video.
Well, that's our journey. Good luck in planning yours. Despite these unpleasant experiences, we don't regret our time in Tirana because it's a place that helped us to grow both in our knowledge and in personal strength.